UNP leader Ranil Wickremasinghe told reporters on Thursday that they have accepted the final outcome of the Lessons Learned and Reconciliation Report despite certain limitations.
When we looked at the report, the UNP identified certain issues. We said there were shortcomings, but nevertheless, this can be the foundation for all parties to come to an internal solution. The shortcomings have been pointed to us. Firstly, the government announced that the LLRC report will meet all allegations against the government and Sri Lanka. We was of the view when I made a statement on 3rd of May 2011 that there are certain charges which must be specifically responded to. But we found certain shortcomings in this report, and therefore we have pointed that out. But we have accepted the final recommendations of the report.
Wickremasinghe also said that the LLRC Commission's findings should be the basis for an internal solution. President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad, appearing on Iranian state television, has announced the production of domestically made reactor fuel for the first time. He also said that Iran would be able to enrich uranium faster. It comes at a time of increased tension between Iran and Western powers over Tehran's nuclear activities. The US State Department dismissed the announcement as not terribly impressive. Iran insists its program is for civilian purposes, but the West fears it may try to build a nuclear weapon. Police used tear gas and water cannons to disperse a protest organized by the JVP in Maligawatha on Wednesday. Hundreds of protesters gathered in Maligawatha to protest against the recent fuel and electricity price hike. The agitators continued the march towards Mardana despite tear gas and water cannon at various places. People living in the area were seen shouting at the police for using tear gas near their residences. Later, a rally was held where leaders of the JVP addressed the crowd.
You can now follow Debrief on YouTube, Twitter and Facebook.